Tyson against them, double agents. I mean, the movie Tony barely covered it. So, hope you got my good side. So anyways, just to give you a little bit of background, and I'll keep this part quick. I could do another five tours just on this part. Even before the Spanish got here, there was trade between the bigger native nations. More and more evidence is emerging of that. So already the logical point to skip oceans would have been Panama. So Panama does have a bit of gold naturally, plus some gold occurring from commerce. Cue the Spanish, Columbus gets to the Americas, he thought it was Asia, everybody thought it was Asia, until Amerigo Vespucci starts sailing down the coast of South America and his map maker says, this cannot be Asia, we found a new spot. They did know the earth was round, Columbus was founded to find a shortcut, not to fly off the edge of the map. That was a bit more propaganda from other empires who were jealous of Spain. Remember, there was a lot of wars in colonial times. So, cue Balboa. The guy on the beer, the guy on the coins, he lands in Panama around what is now San Blas, give or take, and starts conquering the locals. Now, they didn't just wipe out the locals, they actually absorbed them. Every big empire did that. Most of the deaths were because of disease. And basically, he got the natives so fed up that they showed him the Pacific, tell him, you know, look, there's a big kingdom there, you're gonna need reinforcements, talking to Pearl Islands. And Panama thus became the point of passage for all the gold and silver and jewels that were being taken out of South America, namely from the Incan Empire, but not just them, all over. It was the plunder and then the mines. So, yeah, from there already we had a canal. It was a trail about as wide as these two seats, very slippery cobblestones, from Panama City, not very fortified, because Pirates of the Pacific, horrible movie, to Portobello or Fort St. Lorenzo, highly fortified because Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yeah, there was Pirates of the Pacific.
Yeah, those were not a big hit. Although, in a couple hundred years, we may see something about the ones off the Horn of Africa.
Yeah.
Different techniques. So, well, the Spanish eventually kind of gave up on Panama as the point and started using smaller shipments to throw off the pirates. So we lost a bit of importance there. South America starts declaring independence. The US was, they started in the 1770s, and then everybody started following suit. Spanish citizens deciding to go independence. So Panama gets its independence in 1821. We had the option of the Mexican Empire, which didn't really coalesce, was supposed to be all of South America, or the Great Colombia, which was the dream of Bolivar, northern half of South America, but too many generals to have a big congress and make a huge nation. Apparently the only ones who pulled it off properly were the 13 colonies in the US. So Panama ends up being part of the Great Colombia that did not coalesce. Bolivar, he was backstabbed. It was liquid borders all the way up into World War II in South America. So we tried to separate from Colombia a couple times because we were a forgotten backwater province. The US had the train in the 1850s, the first, you could say, industrial canal, even though it was still land-based. And then in 1903, finally, when negotiations between the US and Colombia are failing to do the actual water canal, which we now know today, that is when the founding fathers of Panama figured out basically what you do nowadays when you get pulled over for speeding. They went to Congress, you know, and they said, hey, if it were up to us, we could give you a 100-year lease and you build your canal and set up your military bases. We wouldn't care that you're a rising empire, which makes everybody nervous. Back then it was okay to invade other people, you know, historical context, different culture. And that's what ultimately happened. We declared independence from Colombia, and the US thwarted the Colombian reinforcements, the ones on the Caribbean side. They never got to use the train because it was US owned. And the sailboat that was sent here to exchange cannon fire with the old town, they got spooked off by a couple of US destroyers that snuck up from behind what is now the Causeway Islands, where we're going to. That causeway is artificial, that was built in the first decade of the 20th century as a breakwater to protect the canal entrance from natural currents and sediment deposits, and connect the islands, which were, I mean, in any form of strategic sense possible, it made sense to connect those islands. So the thing is, our first government makes its first mistake and sends over a French guy to negotiate with the U.S., and he didn't negotiate. He signed everything over. And that brings us to the 20th century. The U.S. settled here. These used to be U.S. buildings. There was a little issue with a certain politician I won't mention that he wanted to do a private development here, but these areas fall under certain special laws because it's canal area.